Tom Matthews has got in touch to ask us a question about how to go about painting the stags of Wild Riders. So in this video, we're going to show you how to do that. And the first thing you need to do is paint the entire stag using Xandri dust. Now, for our example here, what I've done is use the spray paint to do this. So straight over the plastic, an excellent start for this kind of thing. But you could paint it by hand if you wanted to. And then what you're going to need is Reichlin flesh shade to shade all over it. Then Xandri dust once again to start dry brushing it. Then Carrick stone to make it a little bit lighter. Then we'll finish off with a highlight of a Shabti bone. So I'm going to go straight to Reichlin flesh shade because it's already Xandri dust, and I'm going to be applying this using my medium shade brush. And we're looking to do an all-over shade here, so across the entire miniature. So be sure to build up plenty on your palette and then start applying it to your model. Now I'm actually going to be looking to apply two coats of this because we've got this extra long fur just around the neck here, and I want that to be a little bit darker. So once this first coat's completely dry, I'm going to paint a second coat just around here. But because the model's quite smooth, just keep an eye on it as it dries, because the shade will have a tendency to run towards the bottom of the miniature and will pool around the feet if you're not careful. The shade is now all completely dry, and I actually added a third coat around that fur around the neck there, just to deepen that colour a little bit more. And now we're ready to start dry brushing. So we're going to start out with Xandri dust. I'm applying this a small dry brush, and this is just to smooth out all the paint on these muscles, in particular anywhere where there might be splodges in the paint. For example, just around the back here, it'll just help even all that out. Now as you do this, the only area to avoid is all the fur around the neck there. Just be careful around that part and paint either side of it. Next, apply a dry brush of Carrick stone, following the same technique but ever so slightly lighter this time. But once again, be sure to avoid all that longer fur around the neck. And finally, we're going to apply a very light dry brush of Screaming Skull across the entire miniature to bring all the colours together. And this includes that fur on the neck. And there we are, that's the vast majority of the body of the stag finished, ready for all those smaller details to be painted in. So Tom, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again very soon.